I-10, I-49, both of those areas closed right now. State police in central Louisiana say between 6 and 8 o'clock this morning, they worked more than 20 weather-related accidents. So for more on what state troopers are doing to prepare the roadways, Trooper Melissa Matey is joining us live on the phone.
Yeah, Melissa, thank you for joining us again. Tell us what's happening with these recent closures and what other roads are closed and what you want to tell us about today.
Well, right now, throughout the Troop B and Troop L, or more the Metro New Orleans area, there are no road closures. Right now, we're currently monitoring the I-55 corridor going towards the Mississippi line and also on the New Orleans side by near LaPlace. We are monitoring that for ice. We have troopers staged in that area. We also have troopers around the Bonnie Carey Spillway area and I-310. Again, just monitoring those roadways in case there is an accumulation of ice. So either we can work with DOTD to de-ice those roads or to shut down those roadways if necessary.
And Melissa, what is also happening right now in Lafayette? We're hearing about the closures along I-10 there in Lafayette between Lafayette and Port Allen, and then also along I-49. Is that just kind of indicative as to what we might be seeing here?
That's really going to depend on the storm. If those roadways begin to accumulate ice and we're unable to de-ice the roads with the help of DOTD, then absolutely we're going to have to shut down those roadways, and that's for public safety. So we're really asking people to stay inside today. There's no need for you to be out on the roads because we don't know what's going to happen. We do know which roads will tend to ice over sooner. However, this storm is predicted to be a little bit worse than what we experienced last week, especially in the New Orleans metro area, even down into the Lafourche and Houma area. So we're working very diligently. We have multiple troops that are working double shifts. We have 30 and 40 troopers out on the road monitoring these roadways. So if anybody sees anything, please call us and let us know. You can dial star LSP, which is star 577, or for updated road closures, please visit the Louisiana State Police Facebook page. You can go to www.lsp.org. We have our road closures listed there. You can also sign up for the NICSL alerts. Louisiana State Police puts all road closures out on our NICSL, which you can subscribe for. Also, 511, you can call them for road closures. 511LA.org is also a DOTD site that lists road closures. So multiple resources for people to view in order to get those road closure listings. But please stay indoors, stay inside, and stay off the roads if at all possible.
Speaking of telling people to stay indoors, seems like so far, Melissa, that people are heeding that warning. A lot of our crews reporting from the field seeing very light traffic, smooth traffic. So far, of course, we're still a little too early into the storm. What is your analysis and what's your assessment of what you're seeing out there in terms of people taking the warning and staying home and the precautionary measures you guys have taken to be vigilant in the storm?
You know, I think the media has done a wonderful job in promoting the people staying home. And I hate to say this, but people saw last weekend when we dealt with this ice storm and just how many crashes were out there on the road. Across the state, Louisiana State Police worked approximately 745 crashes, and six of those were fatalities. So we don't want to see any injuries. We don't want to see any fatalities. Stay at home. Please listen to us. We're not just going to shut down roads just because. We're going to shut down roads when they're not safe for people to travel on, and that's what we're majorly concerned with, is people's safety. So listen to us. Follow the weather reports. Follow the road closures. If you have any questions, please visit our Facebook page. We'll be more than happy to answer those. And stay indoors, stay warm, and stay safe.
All right, Melissa Matey from State Police joining us on the phone. Thank you so much for all your efforts and for being here
Thank
for
you.
Us and giving us up-to-date information on the roads out there. Thank you very much. All right.